Hey everybody, Bill Clark here, and I'm here to do a sermon short where I take the sermon of the week and do it in just a third of the time so that you can watch this and enjoy some discussion and prayer time together. We're on part four of the Deployed series, and we're talking about how changing your home can change the world. In this time of quarantine, we've been at home more than ever before. You might be tired of being at home so much, or maybe you're loving it. But the good news is, home is where God teaches us to really make a difference, because if we can change our families, we can truly change the world. I want to share with you the most memorized passage of Scripture in the entire Bible. No, it's not John 3:16 or even the shortest verse of the Bible, Jesus wept in John 11:35. It's Deuteronomy 6, starting at verse 4. It's called the Shema, which is Hebrew for listen or hear. That is the first word of this passage. And we find some things, three things, in fact, that we can do to change our homes. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength. These commandments that I give you today are to be on your hearts. Impress them on your children. Talk about them when you sit at home and when you walk along the road, when you lie down and when you get up. Tie them as symbols on your hands and bind them on your foreheads. Write them on the door frames of your houses and on your gates. Cool passage, right? And what we see described there is an integration of faith and family. They are not separated at all. They're fully integrated. And when we do that, it changes our homes and it can change the world. So within that passage, let me give you three things that you and I can do to change our homes. Loving God a lot is how you can change your home. Telling stories about God and you. And third, decorating your home with your faith. Loving God a lot. Telling stories about God and you, decorating your home with your faith. It's that simple. Just loving God a lot makes all the difference. That's the greatest commandment that Jesus gave us in the New Testament. And he was quoting the Shema. Love the Lord your God with all your heart and all your soul and all your mind. Love God with all your being. That's how you transform your own life. That's how you transform your home as well. And in so doing, changing the world. So just if you want to know how to make a difference in your family and in the world, just love God a lot. Pretty cool, huh? But also telling those stories about God and you, sharing what you've struggled with, sharing how God has impacted your life, what he's done for you, how you've prayed to him, and how he's answered those prayers in unique ways. In this passage in Deuteronomy 6, it says to talk about these things as a family when you're sitting up and when you're lying down and when you're walking, just in normal rhythms of life, tell the stories of God and you. And then thirdly, decorate your home with your faith. It talks about symbols and tying them on your forehead and on putting them on your door frames in this passage. And in similar ways, you can tell a lot about what's important to a person by how they decorate. For instance, in this very room, I like Kentucky Wildcats. I like coffee. I like running. It's obvious just in this one little room what I really care about. But can someone tell that you really love God by looking at how your home is decorated? Now, I'm not going out there saying that that's the most important thing is how you decorate your home. What's most important is what's in your heart. But what's in your heart tends to come out in some unique ways and is visible to others. And one of those is decorating your home. I encourage you to think through that as a person and as a family. How can we decorate our home, our rooms, our very lives in such a way that our faith in God is obvious to others? Here is the next step I want you and I to consider taking, and that is this. Give some of your life to someone else under your roof. Specifically, think of someone who you live with. How can you give someone you live with some of your life this week? It might be taking your kid out for a kid's date. It might be going for a walk together and just talking about what you're praying about and what you're struggling with and how things are going between you and God. Things like that make a huge difference in a house and in a home by literally integrating faith with the rhythms of your relationships within your home. How could you give some of your life to someone else this week under your own roof? You can't lead your family where you've never been. You can't lead your family where you personally have never been. So here's the thing. If I want to make a difference in my home, I've got to go places with God and say, okay, hey, come join me here. Here's something I'm learning from God. Here's something God has convicted me about. Here's something that God needs to grow me in. And here's the journey that I'm on with God. And come follow me in that journey. Come tell me about your journey. Let's talk about God together. Right now, I would say this, more important than anything else, check your heart and say, okay, do I love God a lot? Do I love Him so, so much that it overflows from my life to everyone else in my home?